What is up, everybody? Circle Flex is here with you guys under the Advent calendar. We're at day 7, and as you might have noticed, we skipped day 6. And that's because I had some food poisoning from Monday to Tuesday, and I woke up today feeling a lot better again. So I couldn't really upload a video. However, you didn't miss much if you didn't check it yourself, because it was only premium time at 15% off or something, which is a pretty shit deal. Especially because NA got half off on the same deal during Thanksgiving. Anyway, with all that said, let's get right into it. So today, day 7 is the KV220-2. Obviously, they're all in bundles. Let's see here. So Asia and EU have the same bundle, and NA is a smaller bundle. Let's take a look at, let's see if they're all unbundled as well. Just checking it out before we talk about the tank itself. It doesn't appear to be on sale separately. It's probably not on the vehicles though. Specials. It doesn't appear to be sold separately at all. That is kind of disappointing. Every once in a while you think like, oh well, they learned finally. No bullshit. And then, oh wait, who is listening to us? No, never mind. These are even more expensive. What the fuck? All right. So for some fucking reason, they decided to not sell this separately at all. That's really dumb. What the fuck? Right, well, I can pretty much say don't fucking buy it. Just on the basis of this, like, it's just retarded to buy it as a bundle. If you don't know what a KV-222 is, we can check it here as well. I compared it to the Churchill here. But if we take a look at things.gg, it looks by stats, I can show you guys what it's all about. I'm not actually sure if I have a replay of the KV-220 on my YouTube channel. If I do, I'll put out a link in the end here. So the KV-220, it was kind of like some kind of like pre-order thing as well for the longest time. But what you mostly need to know about it is that it has a stock KV-1 turret with a stock gun of the KV-1. However, it is on basically a KV-3 hull, which makes the armor pretty damn effective. If you angle just a little bit, you get, you know, 180 to 190, 150, which is more than enough to bounce, you know, most of the things you'll meet. As far as I know, it does have limited matchmaking, just like the Churchill 3, where the weak spot is basically the turret. The turret is really weak, but if the enemy is dumb enough, and they sometimes are in these tiers, to, you know, shoot your turret, as you can see here, 91... 78, that's a pretty significant weak spot. Everything else is pretty well armored for the most part. Tier 5 already will have around 100 pen on most guns. But if at a slight angle, you're going to be relatively safe. It's also a bit bigger because, like I said, it's a KV-3 hull. That's really the only weak spot. However, if you compare it to the Churchill 3, which is like the longest running premium ever, it feels like... It does have some significant weak spots or weak points. The DPM is significantly lower. And even the pen is lower on the standard pen. Although you do less damage per shot, so you get higher alpha per shot. That might be useful in certain situations. The gun handling is worse than on the Churchill, but you shoot faster than the Churchill. So it's kind of like evens out. It's faster than the Churchill with better power to weight, but worse range resistances. So they both feel equally slow. And it has way less view range from 350 to 310, which is a pretty big deal at these tiers, especially with limited matchmaking. If you can get a good crew going in your premium tank, you know, it's always nice to have. So really, is it worth buying? I don't think so. Like, you don't really buy a tier 5 to make credits, tier 5 premium to make credits. For crew training, maybe. But like, you can buy a Churchill at half off a lot of the times during the year. I think it's so here as well, if you look here. So this is €4.47 at 39% off. And This is on EU. I don't think NA or Asia has sales right now for the lower tiers. They don't have like a week special or something like that. But you can bet your ass that tier 5 and below will be 50% off, or like 40 to 50% off, a lot of the times during the year. And I think personally, instead of spending like 25 euros, you're way better off just buying a little Churchill, and keep the 20 euros in your pocket to buy like a proper premium at tier 8 if you really want to make credits. Because for that price, yeah, you get a lot of gold for it as well, but it's not on discount or anything. Like, it's just a shitty bundle, really. Like 4,700 gold, like whoop-de-doo. You know how little tanks you can buy in the tech tree these days? Like, it's not even really worth it. So again, I would just suggest buying a Churchill on half off, and it will probably serve you better than this thing. It's not, it's perfect for ramming enemies. Get the fuck out. You're not ramming shit with this tank. It's so fucking slow. Maybe people will ram you, sure. But there's also no discount. Usually they say like, well, this is a bonus, or this is 100% off, or this is for free or whatever. This is not actually discounted at all. So special offer, my fucking ass, buy a Churchill if you really want one. But I suggest saving your money and keeping that 30 euros in your pocket and buy like a proper tier 8 premium that's either on sale or is like a more rare one. Stuff like that. But if you really want a tier 5 crew member training dude, buy a Churchill. That's what I would say. Anyway, thank you guys for tuning in. We're gonna check back tomorrow for day 8. I'll see you guys then. Don't forget to subscribe, maybe check out more videos, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.